There beyond the grave, there is a land where Jesus went to prepare with his own hand. And for the saved by grace, there is a resting place.
Holy hands, healing grace. Spiritual food. Hallelujah. God is good. Lord, we love you today. We praise your name above everything. Lord, we know, God, that your hand is above everything. And we know, Lord, that by you all things consist. And we ask you, Lord, to touch your people today. Lord, bless your people. So thankful today for every moment. Lord, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Girls, y'all gonna sing something. Man, still like the red back in. Anybody want to sing, man? Y'all, come on. Hey, man, just a few minutes. I think Jubby's coming back now, okay? I want y'all to do me a favor. Help me with the kids, because she's wanting to come back down and be in the service a little bit. So, amen. Y'all help me with them today, will you? Amen. So, we have to, Brent, I know he usually stands there and keeps watch for me. Amen. If you need any mothers or anything, Brent, say, hey, come here and get this baby. Yeah. Amen. It's fine, okay, brother? Y'all, is that all right with everybody? Yeah. Amen. Ain't God good?
All the time.
I tell you, I truly love the Lord today. Amen. His mercy endureth forever. Amen. Love. Amen. It's where it's at, church. Amen. Listen, I can beat you to death with the Word of God. I'll be flat out honest with you. I know I can't. Amen. I know some scriptures I could jerk out of there and just wear you out with. Amen. But I read one, amen, where it says, God is love.
Amen.
I read one where it says, charity will cover a multitude of sins. Love will cover a multitude of sins. Amen. You can do, I found out one thing. You can do a whole lot more with love than I can anything else. Amen. And I always tell the preachers in here, I say, don't preach with your eyeballs. Amen. You preach with what God tells you. Amen. Because I can look back and we can find things. You know what I mean? But that ain't what's in the Word of God. Amen. I always tell all the young preachers that. You know, I'm trying to help them out. What about 287? Amen. I know a lot of the mommies today, quite a few, that would be here, but they're probably what some of the families wanted to be with them. Amen. Sure wish I had my mom here. Amen. I'll be honest with you, she'd probably be shouting right down in the floor. Amen. Amen. She's a shouting woman, that wasn't she for? Amen. You know what? Amen. She's up there doing it now. Amen. Never getting tired, never getting weak. What do you think, sir? Amen. 287. Egypt was once my home, my hook was slain. Help my sins and be drawn. Love like a great thing I looked up to heaven's known grass came to save I'm living. Thank you.
the lowest dream of person we see. My soul was filled with fear, darkness swept in, but Christ the Savior took me through me in my heart to win and out of it. He came in right out. He jumps behind.
Scriptures. If you took it out, then that's up to you. Amen. Amen. But I ain't going to touch it. Amen. Amen. Because he said, in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye, the last trump, the dead in Christ shall rise first. And those who alive and remain will be called up together to be with the Lord in the air. Amen. Hallelujah. You have heard of little Moses in the border. You have heard of fearless Nathan and his son. You have heard the story told of bringing Joseph and of Jonah and the well we often see. There are many others through the Bible. I should like to make them all my duty clear. By and by the Lord will surely let us speak at that meeting and hear. Oh, there is going to be another meeting in the air in that sweet, sweet by and by. I am going to meet you over there and home beyond the sky. So the singing you will hear, never heard my mortal ear, will be glorious after the evening prayer. For the mourners, which will have no place at all. There will never be a servant prince of sinners, for the sinners never need to be at all. There will be no mourning on the wayward world. There will be no nights of weeping prayer. All our burdens and our anguish will be dead. That meeting in the air. There is going to be our meeting in the air. In that sweet, sweet by and by. I am going to meet you over there and on beyond the sky. Such singing you will hear, never heard my mortal ear. Glorious after you declare. And God's own Son will be the leading one at that meeting in the air. Desert doubters will be missing altogether. All the skeptics will be absent on that day. There will be no grumblers
celebration to be stirred up. And the ancients will be busy far away. Barely saints will have this seal upon their forehead. Dressed in rank and the grass and arms in white. All who have the wedding garment will be crowned at that day.
If three went in and three came out, Where'd that fourth man go? Did y'all get that?
Yeah.
I never will forget it. Mama danced around the floor. Amen. Then these are the words I heard her say while shouting through the door.
Amen.
Then that's when she said, okay, what'd she say?
She said he's still in the fire.
Still in the fire, church. Going through, God's still there. Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
Amen. Still remember what I'm telling me all the time. God can take care of us. Amen. I go to her all the time. I say, Mom, this is happening, or that's happening, this problem, or that problem, all through the years that I've been preaching. Amen. If something come up, I go talk to her. Amen. I go talk to Mom a whole lot. Amen. And she'd say, God gonna take care of you. You just hang on, amen. And you know what? God was always there, amen. Prayer changes things, amen. My God, any good, church? Amen. I tell you, I love the Lord. Thank God, amen. That everybody's here today, amen. That we come to praise the Lord, amen. And we love Him, don't we?
Amen.
Sure love Jesus, amen. Without Him, we have no hope. Thank you, Jesus. Go ahead.
It's a hard song.
I know it's hard on your throat because you've been sick. Amen.
Mama and Daddy talked about going home.
dogs, Carter. She said everybody pray for Joe, that they can't get no response out of him. Nurse came today and couldn't get his pupils to dilate or anything. Amen. They think it's progression.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Thank you, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Man, I love Jesus tonight. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Sing out. Amen. I tell you, if anybody feels a tug at your heart and feel like you need to pray, this altar is always open. You come on up and pray. Amen. Don't let nothing stop you. Amen.
Sunlight morning gables, truth is the same. All God's children.
Amen. But I gotta realize, amen, that somebody out here, amen, they get glory. We gotta, amen. I tell you, there's joy in serving Jesus. I'm not sad yet. Amen. I get sad in ways, but in other ways I know that I know, amen, that some people are healed eternally.
Amen.
And that's when they get to the other side, they're healed forever. Amen. Ain't God good? God said he would send down fire. Set the altar on fire. Can we sing? God said he would send down fire. Send it down to Elijah. God said he would set the altar on fire. Can we sing? Elijah was a great man of God. So I sing, I am Mary's moon, the morning star. He struck the hour with a burning fire.
Thank you.
feel the chain breaking. Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Y'all Carmen, are you going to leave? Okay. Go ahead. Kids, let's do something. Amen. It's Mother's Day, and they want to give something to the mommies. Ain't God good? Listen, I don't want to know the mommies leaving. Amen. We got something for everyone. Amen. While they're getting ready, is it going to be a while? It's going to be a minute on the same song.
She would not. I had it set so that they could feel it. After they take these, I want to picture all the moms, not only the ones that got little ones up there too, okay?
Thank you.
You were going to give that to my mom. Let's do that.
Amen. Whether you got a young one here or not, I want every mommy up front right here. Please. I want to get a picture of every mommy. I don't care if the kids are grown or not. And Julie, come up here, will you? And then we got you as an honorary mommy on this thing, okay? We're not giving the flowers and stuff out yet, but I want a picture. This is what I wanted. Amen. So we'll all have to scoot together a little bit. Rain, get over here, please.
Yeah. Yep, Rain.
Every mommy.
Please. I can't hide. You can't hide.
Can you get them all?
I don't know.
Wow, wow. Turn around. Y'all squeeze in real tight as you can. Good church. Amen. While the preacher's getting ready, let's all stand our feet. Sometimes I'd like to give you a little bit of word if I could. Somebody say praise the Lord, or help me, or help me or something. Amen. Honey, nights like this, that's the way it is. Amen. But it's Mother's Day, we thank God for every one of them. Amen. It's in the Bible, Bill. Amen. How many knows if you're gotten, what are you gotten by?
The Word.
Gotten by the Word. Amen. I can do a lot of things, amen, but I tell you what, if you're gotten, you're gotten by the Word of God. We can jump up and down, do everything in the world, but if you're gotten, you're gotten by the Word. And I think that somebody needs to hear the Word of God. Amen. We all need to hear the Word. What's faith coming by? And hearing the Word of God. I want y'all, especially you guys, you men, I want you to look at your neighbor, all of us, and I want you to say this. Where would we be without the woman? Amen. Thank you, Jesus. I'm going to tell you guys something. Amen. You guys, we would all be in trouble. I'm going to be honest with you. I can feel defeated in this world will beat you down. You could be out here on the job site. You could be doing a lot of things that will beat you over pieces. Amen. But then when that woman comes in, she can lay her hand upon your shoulder and she can say, honey, it's going to be all right. You tell me, guys, you don't perk up. You know what, well, man, you'll stick your shoulders back and say, yeah, you know what? I can beat this thing. It's because you got a woman behind you saying it's going to be okay. It's going to be okay, honey. We're going to make it through this thing. How many's been through that? We all have. Amen. Where would we be without the woman? Turn to Judges chapter 4, if you will. God spoke to me this morning. I feel like saying a few things about the woman. Amen. Judges 4, verse 8. Start at verse 8 if you want to. Judges 4 and 8. Amen. I'm going to tell you something about the woman. You think about your mommy. I'll tell you, some of the strongest people, amen, is a woman. They're strong. I'm not talking about physically. I'm talking about, amen, spiritually and in their, amen, and in their mind and how they can hold you up. Verse 8 said, and Barak said it to her, he's talking to Deborah, the prophetess, and judged Israel. He said it to her, if thou wilt go with me, then I will go. But if thou wilt not go with me, then I will not go. Verse 9 said, she said, I will surely go with thee. Notwithstanding the journey that thou takest shall not be for thine honor. For the Lord shall, what's that say? Help me. Sell Sisera into the hand of a woman. And Deborah arose and went with Barak to Kadesh. Okay. That's all I'm going to read. But I done told you, if I could title this, I said, where would we be without the woman? Amen. When Deborah told Barak, she said that God was going to deliver Sisera into his hand. Now, Sisera was a warrior. Amen. He had chariots of iron. Amen. He had many men. And she said, God is going to deliver him into your hand. Amen. The first thing he said was, I ain't going to go unless you go with me. I'm going to be flat down honest with you guys. Amen. If I'm going into a spiritual warfare, a lot of these women I'd like to have with me. Come on, somebody. Amen. Why? Because I believe that women, a lot of them, amen, without them in the church, are in trouble. Amen. Now, I'm not putting those guys down saying we can't do nothing. But I'm telling you right now, amen, we need to be prayed up, fired up, ready to go up like these women. Amen. They work hard for the church. Where would we be without the woman? I tell you what, we'd be in trouble. Come on, guys, can I hear an amen?
Amen.
Amen. We would be in trouble. Amen. And that he was in trouble. But you know what she told him? She said, you can go up and I won't go with you. She said, but you ain't going to get no glory out of this. Come on, son. You ain't going to get no honor out of it because God's going to give it to a woman. Does anybody know what happened in this story? She went with him. They went up. They went in the battle. They won the battle. But a woman, amen, took that big man, amen, that warrior, and she took him into a tent and he fell asleep. Amen. And she laid him down and she drove a tent stake. Amen. A nail through the side of his head, through his temples, into the ground. Come on, somebody. She destroyed that man because God had done said it. Amen. The prophetess had done said it. And amen. By the way, church, amen. Today, amen, there's still a lot of the old ways that say, you know, well, this about the woman and that about the woman. I'm here to tell you, that woman was a judge of Israel. Come on, somebody. I didn't say it, the Bible did. And this is the Old Testament. If anybody wanted to be judged, they went up before this woman. Amen. I can say a lot about the women in the church. Amen. I'm going to tell y'all something about this church right here. Amen. I was looking for a place to go. A lot, some of these people know, amen, I probably might have told this story before. Amen. And I was wondering, I said, well, what am I going to do? Because I go here and go where? Y'all know how it is. You don't feel comfortable everywhere. Come on, somebody. Amen. I just really didn't feel like God wanted me at this place or that place. Amen. So all of a sudden, you know, God spoke to my heart and we had this empty lot right here. And God spoke to my heart and I said, well, we're going to do this thing. But guess what I've done? Started calling the women. I don't think I called a man one. Now some of them might have called. I didn't. Come on, somebody. I started calling, buddy, you going to build the church and you called the women? Yes, I did. Somebody said, praise the Lord in this house. Getting off the quiet. Amen. I started calling some of the women. I said, look, I don't know how we're going to do it, but we're going to build a church in that lot. You know what they said? We've been praying about it already. We done put out a fleece and asked God for you to move in this direction, and we're going to start working on the building. Come on, somebody. Guess what? We're still working on the building. Amen. Working on the building for my Lord, for my Lord. Amen. We're still working on the building. Amen. But you know what? It was kind of like this story here. I was saying, well, we'll start building this church if y'all go with me. Amen. But that kind of the way it was, Lorraine. Amen. Well, we'll start building if y'all go with me. I can look back and I can still see them. Guess what? We're still hanging on. Amen. Amen. The enemy's come in. The devil's rant and raged. Amen. Because sometimes he just don't like us too well. Amen. But you know what? I was telling Brother Stu, amen, today. Amen. I said, sometimes, amen, we don't read the Word of God like we need to read it. We want to read it like Mommy read it or Papa read it.
Amen.
You say, brother, is it different from where they read it? Yeah, because they would stop at one place. Amen. Amen. I don't want to read the whole page.
Right.
Come on, somebody. It's going to get tough tonight.
Amen.
I want somebody, amen, to get Galatians 3:28 for me. I ain't going to tell you that. I'm going to tell you what thus saith the Word of God. I wish I could remember that in 2 Corinthians that I told Stu about earlier. What's it say?
I can't hear you. Say it real loud.
There's neither Jew nor Greek. There's neither bond nor free.
Hang on just 1 second. I'm going to stick this mic under your nose. I want you to say it again.
There's neither Jew nor Greek. There's neither bond nor free. There's neither male nor female. For ye are all one in Christ Jesus.
Whoa, my Lord, help me, Jesus. Would anybody hear that other than me? This is, did I say it? Didn't the Word of God say it? Bubby, you read it, not me. He said, there is neither bond nor free. There is neither Jew nor Greek. Come on, somebody. Amen. He said, there is neither male nor female. We are all one in the eye of the Lord. Somebody say, praise the Lord. Amen. Sometimes we got to read this thing by ourselves. Amen. Because if we don't, we're going to be deceived. Amen. In 2 Corinthians, do you remember that scripture I told you? It's in 2 Corinthians. There's two places, I think. It's 2nd or 1st. Can't remember if it's 1st or 2nd Corinthians. Amen. Where he says for a woman to keep silence in church. I'm going to read this. It's going to get tough, ain't it? Well, I'm going to read it all down, though. I'm going to read all of it. I ain't going to read just that one scripture. I'm going to take the whole Word of God. See, if we just take a piece of it, we're doing not what the Bible says to do. We got to take it off. We got to eat it off. If you don't, you ain't going to make it, church. Come on, somebody say, praise the Lord. Amen. Never seen a pastor talk like that. I'll be flat down honest with you folks. I'm going to tell y'all something. Okay. Can somebody read it?
Let your women keep silent.
Hang on a minute. I got to get a mic under your nose. You boys act like you can't speak loud enough.
Let your women keep silence in the churches, for it is not permitted unto them to speak. But they are commanded to be under obedience, as also saith the law. And if they will learn anything, let them ask their husbands at home, for it is a shame for women to speak in the church.
Hang on a minute.
What?
Hold it. Right here. I want y'all to read what
he's saying. He read all this because this is his church belief. They said for you women to keep silence in church, and if they want to know anything, I've heard this all my life, you know. Let me tell you something. This is what he said in the very next verse.
What?
Hold it.
That's the question. Y'all look in your Bible. It's a question mark. He said, what?
Hang the Word of God out of you?
Hang on. Hang the Word of God out of you. So he's saying, did the Word of God come from you?
Or came it unto you only?
Or came it unto you only? You see, there's a difference. You got to watch what you're reading. He said, what? In other words, this is what they were saying. He said, what? Did the Word of God come out of you? Or is the Word of God coming to you?
Right.
If any man think himself to be a prophet or spiritual, let him acknowledge that the things that I write unto you are the commandments of the Lord. But if any man be ignorant, let him be ignorant.
Thank you, sir.
We'll put it right there. Amen. Now, if any man be ignorant, he said, let him be ignorant. Did you hear what I'm trying to tell you? He said, what? Did the Word of God come from you, or did the Word of God come unto you? You see what I'm saying? They was trying to take and say what the Word of God is supposed to be saying. Amen. And he's telling them this is what this should be saying. He said, if you're spiritual, let you be spiritual. He said, but listen, he said, if you want to be ignorant, then be ignorant. Come on. Somebody say, praise the Lord, give the Lord a big hand clap of praise. And I'm getting this on mothers. Amen. I want you to give me another scripture.
Forbid not to speak in tongues.
Oh, it's the next
verse.
It's the next verse. Actually.
Come on, say it.
Wherefore, brethren, covet to prophesy.
Hold on a minute. I got to get a mic.
Wherefore, brethren, covet to prophesy and forbid not to speak with tongues. Let all things be done decently and in order.
Thank you. Praise the Lord. There's you another one. Don't cost you dime. Amen. We need to pray to prophesy. Come on. He said we need to seek these things. Amen. We need to pray to prophesy, but forbid not to speak with tongues. Is that what the Word of God said? Amen. Come on, somebody give the Lord another hand clap of praise. We're getting in singing what the Word of God says here today.
Amen. This is what the word says, not what Brother Randy says, not what my papa said. This is what Brother Randy reads in the Word of God. If you can take it out, you're in trouble, because he said, if you take anything out of this word, your name will be taken out of the Lamb's Book of Life. Am I right or wrong? If I'm wrong, set me down, send me down the road. But if I'm right, somebody say amen. Amen. My God, ain't God good? Amen. If the world would we be without the women in the church, we would be in trouble. Somebody say praise the Lord. Ain't God good?
All the time.
I'm going to have a meeting with men after this.
We got more women here today.
We usually do.
In the house of the Lord, we're usually outnumbered. Amen. Anyway, let me tell y'all something. Where would Naomi be without Ruth? Where would she be? She'd be in trouble. Amen. Because she didn't want Ruth to go with her. And Ruth said, no, wherever you go, I'm going. Your God's my God. I'm going where you go. Guess what, church? Where would we be without the woman? Amen. My God, amen. Naomi, amen, would have been in trouble. Amen. But she ended up at the, Ruth did, at the feet of Boaz. And I'm going to add this in. It says, you remember me preaching about the Gentiles the other night? Amen. And the Jews. I'm going to tell y'all something else. This kind of represents the same thing. What are you talking about? Because Ruth, amen, she was eating from the field the leftovers, wasn't she?
Yeah.
Didn't the Bible say she gleaned from the fields? In other words, she was getting the leftovers. She was just getting a little bit. That's how she met Boaz. Amen? Because he said, throw her a little more off and let her pick it up. Am I right or wrong? It was representing the Gentile race of people. You see, all we got was the crumbs from the table. Come on, somebody. All we got was the leftovers. Amen. But Jesus came along and said, hang on a minute. These people's going to be right at my feet. Come on, somebody. This is going to be my people. And by the way, Ruth, that was a Moabite. Amen. You look at the first chapter, amen, of Matthew. She's in the bloodline of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Somebody say praise the Lord. Where would we be without the woman? We'd be in trouble. Amen. I feel like preaching. Amen. Everybody quiet. I feel the Spirit of the Lord run up and down me. I can't help it. Amen. I feel the anointing of God upon me. Amen. We need to hear this. We need to hear the Word of God. Amen. And what thus saith the Word, not what thus saith the preacher. Amen. Love to play the guitar. Love. Amen. Listen, this church is going to even let you on the pulpit if you got short sleeves on. My God, what woman's going to lust after my arm? Seen that the Word of God nowhere. If you put it in there, you show me. People don't like me doing this. Take a drink of water while you're preaching. Shouldn't do that, bro. Show me that the Word of God, I'll quit. Amen. If it ain't between the covers, I don't care what you're hollering. Amen. Brother, you play that guitar too loud. Let me tell you something. The Bible said, amen, you better read 150 songs. Praise the Lord upon the tremble and dance. Praise Him upon the stringed instruments and organs. Come on, somebody. Amen. Did they say that or not? Is that what a song says or not? Now, praise Him upon the high-sounding cymbals. Hey, He said that everything that hath breath, praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. I'm going to praise Him. Amen. Praise Him in the dance. It's what He said. Amen. People say, well, I'll dance for him, puts it on me. He did in 150 songs. He said, praise the Lord with the tremble and dance. He didn't say if he felt like it. It was a commandment. Am I right? Did he say, if I put it on you, praise the Lord with the tremble and dance?
Nope. He just says praise
you. So if you see me scooting across the floor, I ain't very pretty. I'll be honest with you, my mommy, she's been gonna be with the Lord. She'd have that hair up on her head. Amen. And she'd be dancing across the floor. Hey, and they'd be Bobby Peels of flying. Come on, somebody. Amen. She was the prettiest thing I ever seen. Come on, church. Come on, sister. pastor done one day. She was up here. She was up here helping cook. They didn't do the dinner sale. And I told her, I said, that was my shout partner right there. I said, we'll start before we clean out this place. Won't we? Yeah. Amen. Sometimes, man, we get together, it's like dynamite. And amen. It's like a dynamite in a fuse. Look out. Somebody puts a little fire to God. Puts a little fire to it. Now, before you know it, come, amen. We're out of here. Amen. We're dancing across the floor. Now watch, I'll tear up my Goodwill shoes. Ain't God good? Amen. Did y'all get that? It must kind of represent my the Gentile-rich people. Amen. We are putting God in everything. I'm going to tell y'all something else about a mommy. Amen. I always did say this. Y'all remember when Elisha was going up and the kids were out and they started cursing. You know, they were making fun of him. They said, go up, old bald head. Remember, be careful. Go up, old bald head. He turned around and cursed them in the name of the Lord. 42 of kids. Two she-bears coming out. Did you ever notice that? She-bears, mama bears. You notice that? You know why? Because they're the meanest. Why? Because they come out, man, and you go messing with their cubs, you're in trouble. Amen. Them mama bears will come out on you with all the claws out. Amen. That's the way God wanted it. Amen. I'll tell you something else. They can say something about their baby, say all they want. My baby's rotten. Amen. Yeah, don't you say it. Come on now. Amen. Yeah, I see you kids out there. I looked at Austin, I went, guess what? Still Jody's baby. Amen. You go fool with him or her, and calls come out. Amen. Am I right or wrong? Where would we be without the women, church? Come on, somebody. Amen. Where would we be? We'd be in trouble. Anyway, I'm going to talk to you a little bit. You know, with Sarah, amen, she couldn't have no children, right? Amen, she was about 90-year-old, I think it was when she had, amen, Isaac, right? Amen, or ain't you leaning against the light switches, man? Amen. And she was, and here, Abraham was 100, right? Okay, anyway, she, when they had Isaac. But before that, she didn't think he was ever going to have any. So, you know, she said, I'm going to give you my handmaiden. Y'all remember, I told you the story about Hagar. And she said, I'm going to give you my handmaiden Hagar. She said, I want you to go in with her and have children. So he went in, she did. She conceived, and she bare a son, and named him Ishmael. Y'all remember? I want to tell y'all something that I never really paid any attention to before. Sarah, God showed me this morning. Well, Sarah, y'all know she conceived when she was about 90-year-old, had Isaac. Abraham's 100. Well, they was going to circumcise him after he was 8 days old, I think it was. 8 days. So he was 8 days old. Okay? You know how old Ishmael was? I looked it up. 14. This baby's 8 days old. Ishmael's 14-year-old boy over here making fun of an 8-day-old baby. But guess what? Mommy said. Huh? Amen. For a time ago. Amen. Amen. See? Mommy seen it. Mommy seen, amen, that he was making fun of this 8 day, him 14-year-old boy. Now, this was Abraham's kid, too. Amen, but it wasn't her child, but it was Abraham's. She said, hey, get the stuff and get him out. You see, where would we be without the mommies? Amen. I'm going to jump in there and say, hey, you ain't letting this baby, this 14-year-old kid ain't going to make fun of my newborn. Out of here. See where your mommy was? Where would we be without the mommies? And by the way, I read y'all that story the other day. She went and set that 14-year-old boy out by himself, and the Lord heard his cry. He's 14 years old. I said he's a little baby. Which 14 years old isn't young, I know that. You know what? If I was 14 years old, my mama tried to set me down over here and take off, I would say, hang on, man, I'm going with you. Ain't God good? But this is what we're going to do without the mommies. Amen. The mommies is what stands up. Says, hang on to me. Amen. Listen. I've seen my mommy rock a car and her boy again, John McGinn. Amen. Throw rocks at a car over one of her kids.
Yes, I remember that.
Brother, you shouldn't say that. Listen, they can't. I can't tell that. Too many people watching. My daddy about whooped me one time for it. They come and got my mom. They was going to take her to jail for rocking that car. By the way, it was a Corvette. Yeah, I got set up on that. There's too many people watching this. But I want to tell you something right now. I kind of laughed about it. My dad got ready to whoop me. Amen. But you know what? That's what would we be without the mommy. Amen.
She was little, but she was massive.
Don't mess with the kids. They'll jump before you hide out, sir. Amen. Ain't God good? Listen, this way his mommy's ever looking at me like I'm straining now. I gotta get back over here. Amen. Ain't God good? All the time. He has never let me down. Let me turn the page. I'm gonna tell y'all something. There was a woman at a well. I gotta get with her. I'm gonna tell y'all something about this woman at the well. Amen. Samaritan woman. And she was at the well and Jesus come by. Y'all remember? Amen. And Jesus, that's the one he looked at and said, if you'd ask me, I got water and I'd give you, you'd never thirst again. Amen. Y'all remember? Amen. She looked at, when Jesus looked at her and he said, woman, he said, go home and tell your husband to come here. And she said, I have no husband. And Jesus said, well, you said it well. He said, as a matter of fact, you got five. And the one you got now ain't your. So he sat there and she said, I perceive that thou art a prophet. Just a little bit later in the scripture, she looked at him and she said, I know that the Christ is coming. He'll tell us all these things. He said, him that is speaking to you now is him. I'm him. You know what she done? She took off. She left her pot and everything. I'm telling you something. We need to leave everything right here with God. I'm talking men, women, and all. She left her water pot there at the well. Amen. And she took off. Amen. We need to leave everything that is holding us behind right here. Amen. Everything, amen, that is keeping us held back, we need to have it right here at the altar. Amen. We need to love one another. Let me tell you something. If I can't love my sister like I love my brother, I'm in trouble.
Amen.
Come on, somebody. Amen. But anyway, she left everything. She left the water pot and everything, and she took off into town. That's what she was saying. What was she doing, church? Thank you. Somebody said it over here. What was she doing? Preaching. She went into town and she was saying, hey, she said, y'all need to come and see this man that told me everything I ever done. I wish we would read that story. Church, we need to read the Bible for ourselves, because right down below it, it said many of the Samaritans got saved because that woman went into town preaching, come and see this man that told me everything I ever done. Surely he is the Christ. Amen. He got good. Where would we be without love? Amen. And I'm going to stop by talking about one more woman. So, Mary, amen, when God spoke to her, and he said, Mary, thou art highly favored. Amen. He said, you're going to have a baby. Amen. Mary was a virgin, never been touched in her life. You're going to have a baby. You're going to name him Jesus. Emmanuel, one scripture said, which means God's with us. Amen. There's people under the sound of my voice that God's wanting to be birthed in. What are you saying, preacher? He's wanting to come into your life, and it's just like having a baby. Amen. Just like way back then. Amen. He's wanting to come into your life, and he's wanting to, amen, be birthed in you. And what will come forth, amen, is things of God. Amen. You'll be talking about Jesus. Amen. You won't walk the way we used to walk. We won't talk the way we used to talk. We'll be talking about Jesus. Amen. We'll be wanting to do things of God. Amen. Come on, somebody. Amen. Am I right or wrong? Where would we be without these great women of God? Amen. We'd be in trouble. Amen. This is Mother's Day. Amen. If you got your mommy, you're so lucky. Amen. Because you can always go to mommy when you can't go to nobody. I used to go to mine. I even remember a time when I was lost. I was lost big of crap. Lorraine was in the hospital. She lost down to 88 pounds, I think it was. She was in intensive care. Amen. She done had pneumonia so bad, and she was allergic to penicillin. They was pumping it full. Amen. They was pumping her full of penicillin, and she was bad shape. So I went to my mom. And I said, Mom, you please pray for Lorraine. I said, because, man, she ain't doing too good. And what she said, you put your knees down here and you pray with me. I was lost. Amen. But I got down. Amen. And we started crying out to God. Amen. She come out of the hospital, I'll be honest with you. I could set Lorraine in my hand and pick her up with one hand. She was so little. Her bones were sticking out of her back. Amen. But God brought her through it. And at the end of my mom's life, whenever we would go to see her, she'd look at Lorraine and she'd say, Lorraine, she said, me and you's like Ruth and Naomi. Wouldn't she? And she would pray. I'm telling you this, God is so good. You see, I got this promise made to me. It don't end with the grave. I'm going to tell y'all that. It don't end there. Just begins. I'm going to get to see her forever in eternity. Amen. I'm going to get to see, amen, all the old saints of old. Amen. And I want y'all to look, all of us together, let's stay in contact with God. Let's keep God in our lives, because all of us are going to heaven together. Y'all hear me? One of these days we'll be together. I may go before you, but we'll meet again on the other side. Amen. But listen, I get to see Mom again. I used to tell them all the time, Barb, I'd say, don't you want to see Mom again? I want to see him again. That ain't why I give my life to the Lord. Listen, Jesus died on the cross of Calvary. Amen. This is the only way you can be saved, is believe that he died for you. Amen. Guys, I want to sing a song. And I want y'all to listen to this song. Amen, because it touches my heart.